Welcome back to Let's Play Starfield Blind Citizens. So, we met BorealUS, like technically 2 episodes ago. She's in, what is it, the Astral Lounge as a DJ. I guess she's a musician as well. She claims her slate was stolen, with all her 3 years worth of doodlings and writings and lyrics and music and stuff. She isn't sure. She's asked me to speak to Mike over at Euphorica in hopes of tracking down the suspect. And that's... she's in here.
You can call me a brand loyalist, but I feel like I just have good taste.
Let's, stay away from Ebside. The locals there don't exactly appreciate the tourists.
You said that plenty of times. This is our third time in Ebside. Hi.
If you're planning on using Aurora, we respectfully ask you do so in the members' lounge.
I don't plan on it right now. Q says he reminded you of someone you lost. Oh yeah, he's the bartender in the area she's just mentioning.
I see you were able to get through to Q, and he trusted you enough to share his journey. You'd be the first. The first moment I saw Q, he reminded me of my big brother, Jun Seng. Like Q, Jun fought long and hard to get where he wanted to be. In his case, a commander in the Free Star Collective military. Sadly, we lost Jun in the Colony Wars conflict. I suppose you could say that saving Q was my attempt at holding on to a memory from the past.
Hmm. Okay. Well, I'm looking for information on a stolen slate belonging to BorealUS.
I see. I'd be willing to divulge this information for the right price.
Well, you know where it is? Why should I pay?
When clients come to my bar, they expect a certain amount of discretion. Eroding their trust is not something I'm willing to do. For free.
How do I know the information is good?
Because when you work the bar, your clients tend to be more honest than they'd like to be. And besides, information isn't a drink that you can sample.
Well, that's true. Doesn't make sense. But BorealUS is an icon in this city. Yeah, just do her this favor. I'm trying to help her out.
She is an icon, among other things. Fine. I'll waive the usual fee.
Hell yeah.
The man you want goes by the name of Stratos. You'll find him at Madame Savage's.
Mm.
He's what you would call a fan of Miss BorealUS's works. Or maybe fanatic is a more accurate term. Either way, he's the one you want. But you didn't hear it from me.
Hell yeah, for that street rat cred. Okay, what kind of a person is Stratos?
He's one of the usual lowlifes you'll find at Madame Savage's.
Stratosphere.
He's also a very fervent admirer of Miss BorealUS and her work.
Fervent.
It wouldn't surprise me if that admiration extended to her possessions. For fans like him, trinkets and mementos are a way to get closer to the one they admire. Fallen stardust.
Huh. So he likes her so much, he'll just steal her stuff. That's great.
May all your journeys be safe.
Thanks. Let's look at the Madame Savage now.
I feel you.
I feel you, buddy. I feel you.
Too bad I can't squeeze
it. Which way is the most optimal way? Supposedly optimal, anyway. Excuse me. The arrows are telling me to get this one, go this way, so you must Get out of my way. Just got it. They said it was at Madame Savage's. Isn't this? Madame Savage is not in Fuji Market.
While we're here, you might want to stay away from the edge of the upper platform. It's a long way down.
Just curious. Didn't she just say it, Madame Sauvages?
You want to see how short my temper is?
So
keep talking.
Have your fun.
I don't like the look of you.
We'll be here when you're
talking.
The hotel Bullseye.
Hold on a second. So looks like it's leading me to Hotel Bullseye.
If the gangs can keep from killing each other, I just might have a good day.
Okay. So maybe this is the quickest way? Go out one upside and into the next? Because this is the way we originally came in. And now we're not too far from it, I guess. One way to go. Oh, person looks strange.
I know your type. The freewheeling.
Enjoy some unique company.
It's freewheeling as you might think. Excuse me. Ah! I see the type over here. So.
Pull up a chair,
I just pulled up a chair. Having something from my personal collection, though. Some Hippolyta for 20% or plus 20% persuasion chance. Ah, what a rush. I look faded.
What's up?
What's
this
up?
Song's got me so zoned.
Oh yeah, man.
Oh yeah, I love her music so much.
Far out, dude. Me too, man.
You're a fan of BorealUS too?
Yeah.
I vibe with that bird hard. She's a beast on the beats. And I love her.
That's right, Cricket.
Got a track in me head right now. Boom! 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 You hear it? It's bloody mood, isn't it?
Bloody right.
I just need some more Aurora so I can get me head bobbing with the wave.
Mm.
Find that zone.
I... Sounds like you're a big fan of BorealUS. Here's my small talk.
Yeah, which is why it pains me to be here and not in the Astral Lounge.
Get kicked out.
I can't stand being away from that place. And But I can't listen to BorealUS if I'm not zoning. That bird song deserves the best eye Aurora can fly.
So it's true you're a fan of BorealUS?
A fan? Lady, I'm way more than that.
A stalker?
I've been following her career since her club hopping days. I know every song, every lyric, and every beat.
Prove it.
I can probably tell you the number of hairs on her head, if you care about that sort of thing. Don't get me wrong. There's nothing weird about it.
No, right?
I just vibe with her music. on like a cellular level. You understand?
No.
In fact, I've made a whole bloody career out of following that woman. Hell, I probably know that bird better than she knows herself.
Yeah, not too creepy. Well, it looks like it was... I was about to, you know, give him some kind of deal. So we can get back to that menu?
Later.
This place is like my second home.
Hold up.
Have you been to the Astral Lounge? BorealUS frickin' rocks!
Yeah, speaking of BorealUS, she needs her slate back. I was told you have it.
Lady, there's no way in hell I'm giving you this.
Oh, so you do have it.
This slate brings me closer to her. As her biggest fan, I feel like I deserve to have it.
Oh yeah, over her? Her own property. How could you steal from your idol?
I didn't steal anything.
It's stole the slate.
BorealUS always says her music belongs to her fans. So I just took what was mine.
That's not the same. This guy has an issue with you as well. I don't think that would hold up in a court of law.
Nah. I'll just cite the oldest law in the book.
Trying to run into him.
Finders, keepers. I'm not giving up this slate.
This guy is, over here is pushy. it's gotta be a way to convince you, though.
Why would I part with the one thing that connects me to her?
So, I do have a... If I fail, I'll give him the Aurora, then. As a super fan, you should do what's best for BorealUS, I think.
Yeah, I do want what's best for her.
She would resent you if you keep the slate.
I don't want that. She should know I appreciate her.
She would be grateful to you if you return it. Wouldn't that be nice?
Really? I didn't think she even knew who I was.
Well, she might now. This slate isn't yours. Don't make me call security. Just do the right thing, dude.
Ugh, damn, you're annoying.
Yeah, huh?
As much as I hate to admit it, you're right.
That was him.
Okay, you can have the slate.
Thanks.
But next time I stop by, I want to hear a mod so sick it beats the piss out of my brain.
I don't have a way of
like
giving that to you. She hates autographs. Okay. I gotta run back over there. I've ever come up this one. Alright. Is there anything different? I spoke to Micah over at Euphorica, who pointed me to a superfan named Stratos. I recovered the slate from Stratos and can now return it to BorealUS. Speaking of which... Music slate. Okay. October 2nd, 2321. Starscapes. Seabirds baying over a passion-bled sky. Ocean waves mewing softly. Whispering furtively to a seashell. Never knowing the seashell will betray its song. The song will cry, the earth is not your father and the sky is not your king. For a canticle of stars awaits those who do not look but leap. Sounds I love. The flutter of a paper bag, hot oil on a frying pan, soft bristles swishing on hard teeth, the boom of a grav jump, the groan of old engines adjusting their bones, the sound of an exhale after a good hug. Ideas and musings. The universe is a song, a melody. We are its notes dancing on interstellar sheet music. I float toward the middle sea, the center of everything, and find the drumbeat of my own heart. I listen to the rhythm of the stars and find plumes of stardust in my own breath. And I know then what was lost will be found again. Ancient vibrations, hymns of the dead, They sing a dirge for those who have not yet lived. Well, that last one was really interesting. It's kind of dark. I like it.
The United Colonies Vanguard.
Hanging out. Just a little bit more, and we'll be just able to run straight in there, probably.
Kind of busy right now.
Good.
Hi there.
Hiya. What's up?
Hello there.
Yeah, hiya.
Get lost. I have a job.
I'll kill you. I will. I'll kill you. Mech Horizon.
Yeah.
Not exactly gonna make it here. Oof. Getting winded going up these stairs. How do you do it all day?
Stay out of trouble, or we'll have a problem.
Oh, how enlightening. Thanks.
There are a ton of distractions in Neon, so I expect you to be on your best behavior here.
Never.
Yes? What?
Death before behavior. I always think I gotta turn around. Alright, how do I get over there? What's up? What do you think I got? Come on. Come on. He's not responding. Okay, I found your slate. Turns out a fan picked it up.
A fan? Really? Although, I guess I shouldn't be surprised. They can get pretty possessive. Doesn't matter if it's my things or my time.
Yeah, I've seen that. Sounds tough. Sorry you have to deal with that, though.
Yeah, it's not all bad. Love can be toxic, or it can be beautiful. Sometimes, people just confuse the two. But, sounds like it all worked out in the end. I've got my slate, which means the people will get their trip.
Mm-hmm.
Inspiration's like a wave. Sometimes, it's hard to catch it before the break. That's what this slate is. A still wave. A feeling frozen in time. And I appreciate you bringing it back to me.
You got metaphors there, I see. Is it still in good shape, this thing?
Yeah, it looked like nothing was downloaded or tampered with. I'm almost glad it was taken by a fan instead of a competitor. Would have been awful to lose that thing. I was working on a brand new concept piece about floating into the center of existence. I'm not feeling it yet.
Okay.
I'm still working out the last few sections, but eventually I'll give it a spin in the Astral Lounge. Thanks again for finding that thing. Next time, I'll try and keep an eye on it.
Yeah, that would be a good idea.
Hope you enjoy the show.
Oh, I'm leaving. I'm heading to underside, underbelly. Under something. Elevator. Where's the control? Alright. Let's get the heck out of here. Time to go to a new district. To us. Oh, we got us tripping going down those stairs.
Got a problem?
Yeah, I got an oxygen problem. You want to hold some stuff?
Good work with the bartender. Won't be the last time you'll be. I'll only carry the good stuff.
She's talking about the bartender from like 100 episodes ago or something. So this is your stuff? You have all this stuff? Oh, you're almost overweight too? That's sad, isn't it? It might be the aid wearing me down. Yeah, because I got 18 amps, so that's almost like 2 pounds of ants. Amps, I mean. 14 heart pluses. I got 30 med packs, so those don't weigh anything. Eighteen synapse alphas. That's probably where all my weight is. Or most of it. I mean, some of this we need to do his... to do Yannick's quest.
Bye-bye.
Alright.
Scram, I'm up.
I hate when they say that. You see me sprinting past you. Get away from me. I'm sprinting past you. You delayed me getting away from you. Oh. Yeah, I'm not going to Aquila City right now. Okay. So out of those things, billboards to hack. The only one we have left to do is... pick a fight with you. The only one left is in the underbelly. Let's see how long it takes to explore this place. Here we can get wet. We might have some people trying to fight us. Because that thing's right here. Did I trouble if someone like a citizen or guard sees me messing with this? I don't know. I guess they don't like that. Security?
What do we have here? Decided to drop by on Neon and do a little vandalism, huh? There's a steep fine for that. Zero tolerance.
Tell you what, you pay the fine now, and I'll let you off with a warning, or things are going to get messy.
So I don't have the same options, and I wasn't detected doing it while I was doing it. Come on, you gotta have something better to do than to shake down a crate rat over here.
You from here? Fine. Get out of here, but don't make me regret it.
I am loving the neon street rat cred. Awesome. Thank you. Paradiso complex? I don't remember this one. An excerpt from the Paradiso Complex, a novel quite obviously written for the Paradiso group in an attempt to market the resort to a wider audience. The writing is often atrocious and hard to take seriously. She felt the warm, perfect air on her face. Mirabella paused to adjust the straps on her bikini, then threw the ball back to Billy, who was sipping a nice, cool, perfectly mixed Perfection Aqua Blast from the Paradiso Cantina. He thought about how just days ago he was toiling away in an office building in New Atlantis, but somehow this trip to Paradiso had been the best thing that had ever happened to him. Paradiso might be the best thing to happen to anyone, he said, as he playfully batted the ball out of the way. Mirabella laughed. I've been to every resort in the galaxy, and none of them are as perfect as Paradiso. She bit her lip and sauntered over to Billy. Do you want to go back to my exclusive Paradiso Beach Cabana rental unit? I got it for a very reasonable price and has all the latest comforts and amenities you'd expect from a luxurious top-quality resort. Oh, boy. Yeah, they're marketing hard with these descriptions. Billy nodded. Yes, and then later maybe we can go to Simon's Rooftop Lounge for some of the best live entertainment and most delicious mixed drinks this side of the settled systems. The rest of the novel is just as painful to read. Yeah, people don't normally talk like that.
There's a huge difference between being prepared and carrying too much.
Stop running if you know what's good for you! You're under arrest. No sudden moves.
I'm not seen until after I pick it up. What the hell?
Search on your fine. Upstanding citizen like you would be a waste of time. Still gotta go to the station, though.
I just got here.
Don't make my job any harder.
You're making my job harder. I took
out of my face. If you want to gawk at something, take it to the astral.
No, gawk at the fish. Fish. Gonna jump on your head. Wait a minute. I guess I can't do anything, because even if I'm not seen, I'm seen. They'll see me after, and be like, aha, I saw you. Like, no, that was after. Doesn't make any sense, right? Doesn't that bring us to where we want to go? Oh, I hacked all the signs. Time to report to... back to Briggs at Madame Sauvage. Okay, we'll do that then. Since I've done that, he can give us our next quest.
Move along.
Madame Sauvage's
place. The fun never stops.
Hey, I'm busy. You want the good stuff? Try somewhere else.
Alright.
Briggs. What can I get you today?
You can get me Briggs. Where is he? Oh yeah, I remember. Hi.
I think you're gonna fit in well. Really well. You've really kicked the hornet's nest. Good.
Mm-hmm.
Andrea's running point on grabbing the gun stash. I need you and Vogel to keep the disciples off balance.
Oh yeah?
So we're finally doing this?
It's time, Vogel. The gloves are off. Both of you, keep the collateral damage down if you can. But it's do or die.
Really? I'm not going to hurt innocents.
If people are in the wrong place at the wrong time, you might not have much choice. Gang fights are no holds barred. So make your peace with it.
Despite your flippant attitude towards innocent lives, Briggs,
she's
we
invisible.
Intend to choose our targets with the utmost care.
You two coordinate whatever you need to. I have a request. I know this is asking a lot. Newell's goods has some armor. Not mil-spec ranger gear or anything, but better than the cast-off clothes the strikers wear. So if you could, well, spring for some armor upgrades, maybe convince Newell to sell it to us?
All right, I'll see what I can do.
All the strikers owe you big time. Any credits it costs, I promise we'll pay you back, with interest. Now's the time for the strikers to make a comeback.
Nice. Level up!
The disciples are gonna pay for all they've done.
Mm-hmm.
We'll talk later.
Finally, Briggs is going to let me kick these disciples where it hurts. I've been telling him to let his best man loose for weeks. So thank you for changing his mind.
Yeah, sounds like you and Briggs have history together.
Yeah, you better believe it. Both of us worked for that hellhole Xenofresh way back.
Oh, Xenofresh.
I was a casualty of a reduction in force. But poor Briggs's leg got crushed in an accident. So Xenofresh, being the class act they are, they fired him. And later, even sued him. So it was him and I on the streets. I helped him through rehab. The Ebside strikers sort of grew around us.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm ready to go after I explore at least most of the underbelly.
You are something else. The plan's simple. We hit the street runners hard in as many points as possible. Maximum chaos. Right?
Right.
Then Andrea can waltz into their weapons cache, snag the big guns, and then the real fun begins.
Mm. And no collateral damage, right?
No promises. The till's running empty. So if I happen to see some marks on the way, then the fishies better pay up. Know what I mean?
Mm. All right, let's get it over with then.
It'll work, all right? Here's three groups of street rats for you. Me and my boys will take some others. Fun time.
The disciples are gonna pay for all they've done.
Really? Clear disciples, hangouts, optional get armor.
I've been dreaming of this. Good talk.
You're going into danger. Anything I can get you? You're going into danger. Anything I can get you?
Actually, I'm gonna do a little restructuring
Always
here.
Always keep your eyes open.
I hope you aren't here to cause any trouble. Maybe you'd like to try a velocity?
Have I talked to her about this? How'd you end up opening a bar on Neon?
Unfortunately, that will have to remain my secret for now. It's safe if the identities of the involved parties remain anonymous.
Hmm.
Let's just say I was owed a substantial debt, and the bar was how I got paid. And leave it at that.
Okay. I could purchase Aurora here?
Administrator Bayou has forbidden any place other than the Astral Lounge from selling Aurora. Now, if Euphorica wants to sell it in their members' lounge, or Legrand wants to mix it into blend, that's their choice. Moi? I prefer to stay off of Bayou's radar and keep Neon security off my back.
Sounds smart. How'd you come up with velocity?
On my home planet, we have beautiful beaches. And during certain times of the year, the ocean lights up in beautiful spectrums of color. Now, science will tell you that this is from tiny microscopic organisms that are emitting bioluminescent light. But I believe it's so much more. Mm-hmm. I think it's a dance, a celebration. It's nature's way of giving thanks to the sun for nourishment. It's breathtaking. Mm. That is the essence of velocity. It's a toast to nature and all its splendid wonders. A sudden merger of humankind to the cosmos.
Sorry, I just felt like I was going to have a coughing fit or something. Oh, growing up on Neon seems a lifetime away. Not sure I'm too happy being back.
You got a look of Neon on you. I can tell. But don't let the other rats hear you complain about your lot in life. Likely you'll get a bitter shiv in the belly for that. Hmm. Precious few managed to escape.
A bitter one.
Either you're lucky as hell, or there's something special about you.
I'll take the latter. I lucked into a mining gig for Argos Extractors. That's how this all began.
Argos, eh? Competition for a slot there can get bloody. I think it might be more than luck that landed you that.
Oh, that was luck.
You do things to survive in the gutter. Every now and then, the good bits. A shared meal, a kind gesture. Mm. But most of what you do to survive... Well, there's a reason why liquor flows like water on this rig.
Oh, remove neon street rat? No. Okay. Yeah, gotta go. I don't wanna remove that.
Me too.
Yeah, I don't know why she came in here anyway.
To Venus?
No.
Have something for me?
To Underbelly. They're gonna give me this stuff so I can sell it. Well, I guess you should use this one. Time to decrease your weight so I can give you some of my stuff. I actually have a pistol that's better than that.
Until later.
Okay.
You're going into danger.
Yeah.
You're going into danger. Yeah. Okay. Oh, she doesn't have money. No. I'll lose money on this. It's all right.
Stay safe.
The Ebside Strikers are finally going to hit the Disciples' back. I need to clear out 3 hangouts of the Disciples to buy time for Vogel to secure the weapons cache. Briggs also asked me to buy some armor from Newell. He claims he'll pay me back. Optional get armor for the Strikers, okay. So I wasn't going to do this yet, but one of their hideouts might be in the Underbelly.
How many...
How should we know?